Adjust stay in Kuala Lumpur for a few days. I visit Kuala Lumpur long time ago, in 25 years ago, something like that. Around 1980, you are not born. And you know, one thing, because I take picture, because I'm a photographer before too. And one thing, you know, on the street, the woman and the girl, they don't have a foulard. You know, my feeling is a Muslim atmosphere is more soft. And my feeling now, 25 years ago, it's, you know, the Muslim atmosphere is more strong. Sorry to say that, but it's my impressions. Another impression is, I think between the community, before it's more easy, I feel that. But now I think it's more difficult. And another thing, quite very interesting, when I shoot in a family, because my topic is the middle class, and I shoot inside the house with the people. And one thing, the people are very open, very open. They have no complex to show everything, because sometimes I go to the kitchen, I go to the bedroom, and no complex about that. And people like to accept a portrait, and they want to go more the portrait, like something like theater, representation. Yes. You know, I compare with Singapore and even in Bangkok, people are more, the people are more strict, you know, more formal. I think it's here, people are, for me, it's quite great, I think that people are not too much formal. I shoot the lifestyle, nature mode, and the portrait, and the situation between two people. And depends when I arrive at the flat or apartment of the people or the house. It's for me, I must to look very quickly and to understand the feeling of the people, the feeling of the house. And after, it's the reason why I take time, because I'm very excited to discover one house and the people, because it's a new for me, you know. And I'm very excited, and it's very important to talk with the people and to take a time and to see around and to understand, and after to choose what I shoot, because after, for each family, I want to do a story with the still life or the portrait or the part of body, you know. But this kind of thing, I love to do that, because when we I am foreigner, you know, and when we arrive in a house to meet some you know, people and a family, you know, me, I don't know the story of the family, and I want to speak with the family to know exactly, you know, to know the story. For example, sometimes it's a Chinese family. It's interesting for me when the grandfather arrived in Malaysia, where they're from China. You know, I try to do constructions of the story of the family. And for the Malay too, because they're from the kampong, which kampong, and what the grandfather do. Because my topic is middle class, and you know the middle class, like in my country, you know, it, you know, 30 years ago, you know, some people from the middle class is a worker, you know, countryside, and now they live on the town, it's a different life, you know. The children go to school, go to university, you know, the society change and up. That's very interesting. For me, it's important. It's a frame and the light. It's quite very important for me. And sometimes the still light is very difficult, and because somehow they have a lot of sea, and it's difficult to shoot when you're still alive. It's difficult to shoot the frame because we must, you know, it's not like a movie, you know. It's we shoot one spot, you know. And you must to understand, it's just one image, you must to understand for the form, for the light.
Where you are?
Where we are, and the aesthetic too. I worked for 10 years in Russia, and to do a story about common apartment. It's not like here, you know. You know, in Russia, it's from the revolution, from 1930. They have a beautiful bourgeois apartment, very, very huge. And after the war, before the war in 1930, they decide they go in your apartment. For example, you have a beautiful apartment inside the Kuala Lumpur. And 300 square meters, for example. And you have 10 rooms. And you know the Soviet of the district, they come and they said you have very huge, very beautiful apartment, but you need to have your 10 room or 8 room to put the worker or the countryside to come to work at the factory. Okay, and you are owner and you can keep two rooms, but the other room is the other people from the countryside who don't know, the owner don't know, you know. You imagine the life, you know. And I do a story about that because they have a lot, especially in St. Petersburg, they have a lot of apartments like that. And I do a story, I do a movie, documentary movie, I do a book. And we do Bangkok for the tourists, Phuket. And Malaysia, sorry, but nobody knows exactly where is Malaysia, okay. And me, I know South Asia because I travel a lot. And I spent when I was a young girl, I spent 10 years in Vietnam, Cambodia. But I know this. And I decide to, because when I come in Singapore one time, I see and know in Bangkok, I know here, you know, the middle class, you know, the these three countries, you know, they grow up very quickly. And when you have this kind of thing, you know, the middle class grow very quickly. And they have a modernization, you know, the society. And for me, it's quite very interesting. And this is the result of my project. And I shoot three capitals of South Asia, but in a peninsula. I don't want to go in Indonesia and in Philippines, because I want to shoot three capitals in peninsula, you know, Singapore.